This one I quite like too.
And stuff like that.
Yeah, yeah, and
this and that and the other.
Yeah, and then one more there.
Cram it up your scabby fat.
Marcus, that's disgusting.
That's the one.
That is disgusting. Hey, now we've got one empty one down the bottom there, John.
Have you got, because my favourite one of Marcus is, what was it? Trousers exist.
Yeah.
Yeah, can you do that one?
Can you do
trousers
that?
Exist.
Oh,
I mean, what more do you need?
Nothing. Yeah. No, just wear a top and some shoes.
Yeah, obviously, got... yeah.
We can. What's that?
I said we love you, Dark Horse.
Okay, that's very
well,
good.
Well, you can tell him afterwards, but I think he's straight.
They love you. Now, that ringtone, like all the others that are on here, will be available to download on the website. For now, big thank you to Dom Jolly. Thank you, sir.
Thanks, Dr.
Still to come, the M&M of self-enhancement, L. Vaughan Spencer helps Marcus adapt to life post-BB, plus results and reactions of the final nominations of the year. We'll see you in three.
Like I said, I'm only going to address the issue with you if I became a housemate, which is why I never came up to you to resolve
you've
it.
You've never even... Yeah? No. Housemate.
Yeah, but this is what I'm saying. That was then. Well, hold on, what is the issue
why
to resolve? If
now?
Someone's boring, how can that be resolved?
Conversation with Siavash, Sophia said, if I don't go, I'm voting for the leader or that person every week. There's nothing exciting about her. What's fun about her?
Welcome back to BBLB. It's 6:15, it's day 89, and I've got some breaking news for you. They've just played in an old episode from this series, which the housemates are going to have to recreate at a later date. Check this out.
This is brilliant.
1:37 p.m.
Please jacket.
Siavash and Noreen.
I'm reading Noreen before one of us goes.
Yeah.
We really need to have a chat.
Oh, Siavash.
Right.
He's everywhere. I'm not listening to this.
Now, my next guest has been watching the show since week one, and he thinks he can help keep the housemates energised and focused in the final week. He's a self-proclaimed gangster motivator. It's the succeeder, L. Vaughan Spencer, everybody. Yes, L. Vaughan. Now, firstly, should I call you L? Should I call you Mr. Spencer? What would you like me to call you?
Elvo.
Elvo.
Yo, I is not J-Lo, I is Elvo. I is your tutor for the future. I hope it suits you. I am the impresario of your best-case scenario. I am the hip-hop hypnotist. I put the funk into dysfunctional. Yo, get off your couch, you slouch potato. I is the gangster motivator.
Wow, how about that, everybody? Now, you felt compelled to come on the show to try and offer some advice for our remaining housemates, right?
Yeah, that's right. A lot of self-help gurus, it's all talk, talk. I'm very practical. I'm all about doing. Everything I say is do, do.
Right, OK. Oh, they got it. It was a bit slow on the uptake, but they did get it, yeah. Who in particular do you think needs help?
Oh, I think they all do, but especially Sophie.
Oh, really?
Succeedy Sophie.
Why not?
Well, why not? Wouldn't you help her?
Right.
But also, I don't think Rodrigo needs help. He understands the importance of tantric tantrums.
No, you're absolutely right, he does. Now, five of them will make it to the final on Friday. What should they be doing in order to win?
Well, they should be reading my book, Don't Be Needy, Be Succeedy, The A to Z of Motivitality.
Oh, here's a wonderful book, actually, yeah.
But they're not allowed to, are they?
Not allowed, no. If we could play any music into them, what would you suggest?
They could have some succeedy music, for example, Succeedia by Phil Collins.
Yeah.
Or
80s classic.
I Should Be Succeedy by Kylie or Calvin Harris, Succeedy for the Weekend.
Oh, three great choices. And now, unfortunately, the house lost its very own Mr. Motivator just last Friday. Have a little look at this.
I'm 100% man. Unless I get the perfect thing, then I'm not interested.
Come on, get with the programme.
Washing your clothes in the middle of a task when you're supposed to be practising, I mean... Seriously, come on.
Paul!
Everyone's just been a bit too negative about it.
Do what I say and use the best man for the job.
Listen, keep the energy up. Huh? Finish strong, more body movement.
If I don't get 100%, I have to do it again, have to do it again.
Well, the harder it is, the harder you should try. And then the happier you'll be afterwards.
I'm not getting a lot of positivity from you, and I think that needs to change.
And here he is, it's only Marcus. Let's get motivated, everybody. Three days on the bounce I've been hanging out with you, Marcus. I feel honoured. Now, you're obviously a very motivated guy when you're in the house. Was it difficult trying to draw some passion out of the rest of them to get things done?
Yeah, initially it was, but then as soon as I locked in the stair,
right, that's
stuff
it.
Got
it,
done.
He dealt with it, yeah? Now, obviously, as we know, Marcus is very motivated. Do you think you can help him be even more motivated, Elvo?
I'm not sure. He's an example to us all. He understands tong shui, which is the feng shui of hair. For example, his succeda sideburns, they prevent his good ideas from running away.
Right, yeah.
And also, he cuts his armpit hair, and the ponytail prevents him being attacked by the dragons of failure from the back.
Right, OK, so he's covered, basically.
He's covered. You could learn a lot from him, but the thing is, are you eating the right kind of things? I think you could. Yeah. Remember, sticky-up hair frightens children. That's all I'm saying. But the thing is, you've got to be eating the right things. Both of you, George, you could learn this as well. Are you eating the right things? The alphabet diet. You should be eating food that begins with the same letter as your name.
I like this.
Elvon Spencer, I eat lamb, leeks, liver, lettuce. George, you should be eating gravy, goose, gherkins.
Greens
and Greek food.
Right,
whereas you, Marcus, you should be eating, and we've got them all here, mince, milk chocolate, meat, melon, marshmallows, meringue, mushroom, mixed veg, and Mexican food.
Wow, right, OK, that works. Have we got anything we might be able to motivate the audience with, Elvis?
That's a good idea. Let's do the succeda dance. This is really good. For this, now you'll need the succeda fingers. Let's try the succeda fingers. Oh. There we are. It's an L. L for life, love, and lamb.
Lamb, oh, yeah. We like that.
Okay, let's hear a shout. We can do it.
We can do it.
I can do it.
I can do it.
Okay, everyone stand up. Let's do the succeda dance. You can do this at home too. Okay,
let's stand
do it.
Up at home now, guys.
It goes there like this. Don't be needy. Be succeeding. Don't be needy. Be succeeding. Don't be needy. Be succeeding. Yeah.
Don't.
Okay, that's enough. Thank you.
Now, don't you feel pumped, guys?
Of course, yeah.
Marcus, will you be following Elvo's advice?
To the letter.
Really?
The letter M.
The letter M. Now,
for motivitality.
I believe you might have done a little special song for Marcus, is that right?
I do this for all my clients, a motivational rap, a moti-rap, if you like, a moti-rap for you. Marcus, you are the irrepressible dark horse. He's a tour de force. He shows no remorse. He likes to rave hard in the graveyard. His mum's Diane. He's an angry young man. He's 35, not 50. But he'll give you short shrifty when he's heading for a nifty, swifty graveyard shifty. But, Marcus, you will never fail with those sideburns and that ponytail.
Yeah! Ladies and gentlemen, Elvo and Marcus, give them a big round of applause. Now, for the final time this series, let's go to the house for the result of this week's nominations. Over to you, Big Brother.
The housemates facing eviction this week are Siavash and Charlie and Sophie and Lisa and Rodrigo and David.
Thank you, darling.
Everyone's up. As we already thought we were anyway.
Yeah.
No bother. One mate.
Sick. Told you.
One housemate will be evicted from the Big Brother house on Tuesday.
We knew that. That's what we expected, didn't we?
Now, in keeping with every eviction ever, the decision is yours. Go to channel4.com/Big Brother for news about when the voting lines will be open. Marcus, what do you make of that, mate?
Fun.
Everybody's up.
Get it done.
Get it done.
Yeah.
Get it done. Do you think it's fairer that everybody's up?
No, I think a small fit of punishment would probably be hand grenade baseball. But
you guys have got some pretty dark games you want to put in the house.
We play the same games, actually.
Right, yeah.
Hand grenade baseball sounds good.
Yeah.
He likes the sound of that. Who would you have voted for had you still been in the house?
I don't know. Just because the boredom mix it up, I reckon Charlie and Rodrigo.
Really?
Yeah.
Charlie and Rodrigo.
Put some favourites up against each other.
You meanie.
Right, OK. And Dom, do you think there's anybody in there who doesn't really deserve to get to the final?
Well, David, you know, I've already said I don't like David, but I wasn't here when he came in. But from the sound, everyone's saying, Lisa, I'm going to go on my before I went to Canada vote.
Right, okay.
Lisa caused a lot of problems.
Don't give
early
in to
on.
Peer pressure.
Yeah? He's
that's
right.
A good
no,
rule for
it.
Life.
Yeah.
Get
rid
but
of
this
Rodrigo.
Motivational speech is really, you know, it's taking off on you.
Stealing his life.
You are right. Get rid of Rodrigo.
Elvo, I'm going to ask you, someone's going to be pretty gutted. They're going to get booted out just before the finale. What advice would you give for them on how to deal with it?
moisturise. Really? Make sure your skin is fully hydrated. That's what I say. Drink 12 pints of water a day and moisturise. Do you moisturise?
No.
Exactly.
Right. Marcus, finally, mate, who do you think is going to win, fella?
I think... maybe Roddy. I'd like Lisa to win, though, because she'd make the best of the
Lisa
money, I think.
Lisa or Roddy. All right, well, listen, guys, we'll have to wait and see what happens. Please give all my guests a massive round of applause. Thank you very much. That is all for today's show. Make sure you watch the main show tonight at 10 on 4, and I'll see you back here on E4 tomorrow at 6 with Rab Wilding and Julia Simpson. Take care.